Now, we're looking into Ford's transmission problems tonight because we've learnt lots of you have been hitting dead ends when you've complained to the car giant.
Jill's been across the case around the country meeting dissatisfied customers who say despite meeting all the criteria, Ford is refusing to fix their cars.
So, what's Ford's response?
The lights are on, cameras rolling, chairs ready.
It's all set up for Ford. Because we think they have some serious explaining to do.
But, oh, as you can see, Ford's not here. Instead, they sent a statement. So we got a master of trickery to help.
Hey, hey!
Because some customers feel Ford's used every trick in the book to fob them off.
Now, we had some very specific questions to Ford, so here goes.
Why did it say it was a warranty issue when it's not? Why say buying a car from Turner's rules out compensation when it wasn't a problem for our original complainants? And does Ford have a database of service records from Ford dealerships? Yep, no answers to any of those questions.
I should have taken a bet with you. I knew they wouldn't.
Wade's one of Ford's fed up customers.
I think it's been appalling, to be honest.
There was so much we needed to know, but all Ford said in its first statement to us was, it has a set of guidelines for making decisions. It's resolved many cases for cars outside their original warranty, cars with many owners, and ones serviced outside its network. It says service history is critical, and that it mustn't be too far out from the required schedule.
Maybe your service was actually done too early.
I don't think so. We had it done at 34,000 kilometres and, you know, the reasoning says that it doesn't need to be done at 59,999 kilometres, does it? You know, it's well within a 60,000 kilometre time frame.
Ford also says for work done outside its network, it needs details, like which oil was used, to make sure Ford's requirements are met. And it said when it comes to what our complainants have told us...
Jill, pick a card.
Ace of Spades.
And for dealers' records, there are discrepancies.
The problem is they won't tell us or the customers what those discrepancies are.
Instead, it asks that customers contact them.
Well, I thought I did. I was in touch with them many times.
Given that they did refund that first couple, can you see any reason that your situation should be different and not worthy of being compensated?
There's certainly no reason why they shouldn't stand by what they did for the other party that you viewed a month or so back. And probably more so, because I think our car had done less kilometres.
We feel his frustration, so we kept pushing and kept pushing. And at the 11th hour, Ford gave us a little bit more to go on.
It's confirmed it does have a database of service records. And as for those discrepancies, well, for Kelvin, Ford's still saying the records of his first service don't match. It's standing by the fact the full service was 9,000 kilometres too late to be considered. However, the company's asking for more details from Kelvin, which is progress. As for Steve Turner, again, Ford's seeking more information. And Steve now says he has proof from a dealership of a service that doesn't appear on Ford's database at all. So watch this space. There's good news for Steve Gregory as Ford has agreed to review his case. But unfortunately, Ford's not saying the same when it comes to Wade Bishop's problem, for reasons that neither Wade nor Fairgo can understand.
They just built up the opinion, I guess, with us that they're certainly definitely not interested in addressing this issue as you'd expect.
But there could be another option for customers who are feeling unheard, a possible class action against Ford.
If you're one person with one potential issue, it's not really cost justifiable to go and engage a lawyer.
It's early days, but there is a chance the class action could be fully funded.
We've had discussions with the litigation funder, which have been positive.
So it looks like Ford's transmission trouble may not disappear anytime soon. Unlike our magician.
What a saga. Mm. I'd like to say the words, but we'll stick with saga. Well done, Jill, for persevering, but it's not over yet. Ford has been drip-feeding us answers over the last few days. I don't know why they just don't sit down and talk to us. Answers which we think should have been given to their customers a long time ago.
That's right. We will let you know the outcomes. In terms of advice for you at home, keep every piece of paperwork relating to your car.
It's boring, it's tedious, but it's really important because no matter what brand you've got, the paper trail is all you have, and it might be up to you to prove your case.
That's right. If you're keen to know more about the possible class action, head to our Facebook page.